In the 16th century BC, the Hittites mentioned a land to their east called Hayasa Azi. The name of Hayasa has long been linked with the Armenians, namely due to the similarity to the Armenian self-appellation Hay and Hayastan, the native Armenian name for Armenia. But is there really anything linking this mysterious Hayasa Azi to Armenians? Unlike other ancient peoples of the region, such as the Hittites and Hurrians, there are no known archaeological sites definitively connected to the Hayasans, nor are there any primary texts from them. Everything we know about them comes from a few treaties they had with the Hittites. These texts mention the names of 5 kings, some deities, as well as cities and towns all lying within the region of Hayasa Azi. In this video, we'll go over the little information we have and see if we can learn anything from them. First of all, where was Hayasa Azi? Although the Hayasans were Hittite vassals, they revolted a number of times, leading them to clash with the Hittites. At one point, Hayasa Azi actually conquered the Hittite religious center, Samua, a city located somewhere near Sivas. And we know that Hayasa Azi at least partially geographically corresponded to the later Lesser Armenia, and possibly parts of Greater Armenia as well. Lesser Armenia, and specifically the city of Ani Kemach, would later become the location of the royal tombs, treasuries, and many of the main temples of the chief gods of the Kingdom of Armenia, such as Aramast, Anahid, and Meher. This highlights the importance of this region in ancient Armenian culture. So while the Sivas region seems to be the western border of Hayasa, scholars do not know how far east the land extended, with some suggesting that it went as far as Lake Van, the city of Erzurum, or even further into the Caucasus region. We also don't know about the exact connection between Hayasa and Azi. Were they separate lands or tribes that united, as is commonly thought? Or was Azi simply a region of Hayasa, as others have speculated? Or did they have a different relationship? As we have no examples of writing or archaeological sites from Hayasa Azi, it's hard to say with any degree of certainty. However, we do know that during the middle of the 2nd millennium BC, there was an expansion from the South Caucasus westward into modern Turkey. Ceramic wares connected to the Trialeti Vanatsar culture appear as far west as Erzurum by the 1600s BC. Due to the burial practices and ceremonies, artwork, and genetics, scholars believe that this culture was Indo-European. So we have a likely Indo-European culture, which expanded from the Caucasus and modern Armenia into eastern Turkey, and within a couple of centuries of this expansion, the Hittites began leaving texts complaining about the pesky Hayasa Azi. From Hittite records, it seems like they viewed their eastern neighbors as lesser than them. In one treaty, the Hittite king Shupiluliuma I calls the Hayasan king Hakani a lowly dog. Ironically, Hakani was married to Shupilulila's sister, making the two kings brothers-in-law. With the family drama out of the way, it could be worth looking into what the name Hayasa Azi itself means or where it comes from. While little is known about what language or languages were spoken in Hayasa Azi, there does seem to have been the presence of an Indo-European language other than Hittite or its closely related languages. In fact, if we look at the surviving people and place names associated with Hayasa Azi, it is possible that Armenian was one of these languages. Let's start with the name Hayasa. Asa is a Hittite and Luwian possessive suffix, so Hayasa could mean high land in Hittite, which is essentially the same meaning as the modern name Hayastan. Scholar Vartan Matyosyan extrapolates that Azi was the actual name of the Hayas domain. According to him, Hayasa Azi may not have been a confederacy of two separate lands, but rather a Hittite translation of the Armenian Hayots Azen, literally saying Armenian tribe. Armenian writers in the early modern era placed a region called Azenzik in the same region that Azi is believed to have been located. This could be an Armenian form of Azi. One of the most popular theories regarding the origin of the word hi is that it comes from the Proto-Indo-European word heos or ios, meaning metal. And nearly a millennium after Hayasa, the ancient Greeks referred to a people living in this general area called the Chalybes, whose name means iron steel in Greek. The first century Roman geographer, Pliny the Elder, wrote about a people in this area called Armeno-Chalybes. Armenians were also mentioned in Xenophon's book Anabasis, living in the regions around Lake Van. So perhaps the Armeno-Chalybes were Armenians living in northern or western areas. Centuries later, a city called Ea was mentioned by the Urartians in the area of Lake Çildır, Turkey. It is possible that this was a memory of the name Hayasa. This might be a good time to start looking at some of the city names of Hayasa Azi. The ancient Armenian city Ani Kemah, now called Kemah in Turkey, was called Kamaha by the Hittites and placed in Hayasa Azi. According to prominent linguist Haracha Ajarian, Kamah could come from Gemach, the Armenian word for skeleton. Perhaps this referred to the city being the location of the royal tombs, as later Armenian kings buried their dead there, or that it was one of the main cultic centers of the goddess Anahit. Interestingly, a Georgian scholar, Georgi Leon Kaftaradze, says that an old Georgian name for Armenians was Komechi. This could mean people of Kamach. Incidentally, the modern Georgian name for Armenians, Somekhi, may come from the city on the border of Hatti and Hayasa Azi, Samoa. If it does, Somekhi could mean people of Samoa. Another city name of Hayasa Azi which could have been Armenian is Arhita. The Urartians, who appeared 400 years or so after Hayasa disappeared, mentioned a city called Arhi. Arhi in Urartian would mean land of the Ar tribe, and likely corresponds to the Armenian Harg. However, it is possible that Arhita was a Hittite name. Arhi meant boundary in Hittite. The city of Ingalova may have been the important Armenian religious center Angertun. Another Hayasan city name, Arzia, may derive from Arzat, the Armenian word for silver. According to Moses of Horin, the Armenian patriarch Haig was the son of Togarma. Scholars have long believed that Togarma may have been a mythologized version of Tegarama, a city mentioned by the Hittites. Some scholars have placed this city in the Sivas region or in the eastern Cappadocia area. This means that Tegarma was in or near Hayasa Azi. Next, let's look at some of the people's names from Hayasa Azi. We mentioned previously that one of the kings of Hayasa Azi was named Hakani. The other four surviving Hayasan royal names are Garani, Muti, Aniya, and Maria. These are the only personal names that we have that are definitely connected to Hayasa. Hakani could be a Hittitized form of Haig, the popular name from Armenian mythology as the founder of the Armenian nation, or Haigak, a legendary ancient Armenian king mentioned in the early medieval records of Moses of Horin, who is regarded as the earliest Armenian historian. Alternatively, a different translation of the name, Hukana, could be related to the word for grandfather, Huha, in Luwian, an Indo-European language closely related to Hittite. Likewise, the name Garani has been connected to Garanos, a name used by Greeks and ancient Macedonians. As Armenian is generally thought by linguists to be most closely related to Greek and Indo-Iranian languages, it would stand to reason that some ancient Armenian names would be similar to ancient Greek names. It is possible that this name survived into recorded Armenian historiography as the legendary Armenian king Gar, who was also mentioned by Moses of Horin, or Garen, which is a popular name amongst Armenian men to this day. However, Garen is generally thought to come from an Iranian source. Another name that has a close Greek parallel is Mita. Mita was a king of a state neighboring Hayasa Azi. A later Mita, associated with the Mushki people, is believed to have been the inspiration for the famous king Midas of Greek mythology. The name Mita could perhaps be connected to the Armenian word mid, meaning mind or intellect. Some scholars have linked the name Maria to Maria, a a Sanskrit word meaning young man or warrior. This term was used in the kingdom of Mitanni, which was located to the south of Hayasaasi. However, historian slash translator Vartan Matyosyan has suggested that the name Maria could instead be a form of the Armenian Mari, also meaning young man. Both Armenian Mari and Sanskrit Maria come from the same Proto-Indo-European root, Merios. Finally, Ania could be an Armenianized form of the Hittite name Anhita, or perhaps is related to the name Ani, which, although now exclusively a female name, in the past referred to a few important Armenian cities, one of which was located in Hayasaasi. Next, let's look at the deity of Hayasaasi. We have the names of several of the gods that were worshipped in Hayasaasi. Some of their gods seem to have Armenian names or an Armenian connection. The most striking is Unag Astuas, which obviously contains Astvats, which means god in Armenian even today. Baltaig could be a form of the Semitic goddess Balat, but with the Armenian suffix ig, which was also used in the name of the Armenian goddess Astrig. Finally, the god Teritonis could be related to the Greek god Triton. Now that we went over the names of people, cities, and deities from Hayasaasi, let's look at what else was going on in the region around that time to see if we can find more clues about the Hayasans. In the 1200s BC, shortly after Hayasa disappeared, the Mushki Urumu and Kaska Apishtlu peoples invaded Assyria from the north. The Urumu and possibly the Mushki have been tentatively connected to Armenians. The Apishtlu, on the other hand, have been connected to the Abkhazians. Apparently, in Abkhaz legends, they say that they were ruled over by the Hyksos people. One of the Hyksos tribes was called Ermj. Obviously, these names look like Hai and Arme. The Mushki and the Urumu moved southeast around the time the Assyrians began writing about the Nairi Confederation in eastern parts of Asia Minor and northern Mesopotamia. It is possible that the name Urumu was actually pronounced Aramu, which is noticeably similar to the name of the legendary Armenian patriarch Aram. The Urumu are believed to have given their name to Arme, a district of Shupria near modern Sassoon. It is possible that Armina, the earliest uncontested name of Armenia, is Arme plus the Iranian suffix na, meaning land of. In other words, Armenia could literally mean land of the Arme people. The Mushki, on the other hand, may have lent their name to the city Mush. And finally, the ancient Greek writer Herodotus, writing in the 5th century BC, famously said that the Armenians were colonists from Phrygia. The eastern parts of Phrygia would have partially overlapped with where Hayasaasi had been centuries before. To conclude, we don't know what the exact relationship is between Armenians and Hayasaasi, as there isn't a lot of concrete information about Hayasaasi. But from what little we do know, it seems very possible, if not probable, that Hayasa is connected to Armenians.